got them all and has made batting ball striking extremely difficult.
Yeah, Butch, the average first inning score at this venue in the last five innings, just about 130. So it's a low scoring pitch.
Whacks up in the air, off the outside edge. Doesn't matter how you get him. Robbie Freiling never had a chance of tracking this down. Neither did Munro in the previous over. The thrashing edge. Look how it just races away with the dew factor in. I know it's not the biggest ground going round in the world. He goes hard with the hands as Primus.
And it's the second time he's used the edge to good effect. Aiming for leg side again. An adjustment in the field for Sunil Narayan. Protection behind point on the offside.
Primus Beef struggling to find the middle of the bat here against Sunil Narayan. Who's going to be in the Dream 11? Who's going to be in your Dream 11? Suggest that one or two of the Indigo Knight Riders bowling attack might feature. For more details, log on to dream11.com/points. Get involved in this wonderful game, Euro CPL Dream 11. Tanvir renowned for opening those big shoulders up, big heaves over the leg side. Being extremely watchful. I think he knows Narayan's only got one ball left. I'm going to try and play him out. And he does so successfully. As long as he hasn't run himself out. I'm going to have a little look upstairs. Nigel Duguid. Let's get fired up here. Smashed. Poles, lights came on the zingers, and, or does Dinesh Ramdin hit them? Yeah, keepers hit him. Dinesh Ramdin, he's broken the stumps over. There'll be hunky dory for Sahail Tanvir.
And more importantly, his bat was behind the line, even when the ball came in. So he would have been saved had Dinesh Ramdin not dislodged the bails. So they'll be looking for boundaries. Tanvir must be accustomed to facing Shadab Khan. More importantly, he'll be spinning into the left-hander. So he could afford to hit to leg, hit with the spin.
Oh, that's big. That's what he's been looking for. Huge hero maximum for Tanvir.
Exactly what I said. It's a good option to take. Tanvir, he knows it.
To hit to leg.
Doesn't commit himself too early. Look at this.
Oh, that opens that front leg. That's what he's been looking for.
And he's got the reach, the power, the long arms.
Huge maximum for Tanvir.
Exactly what I said. It's a good option to take.
Really like bowling that much to lefties.
He knows it.
The situation.
Look at this.
Prefer to be bowling to right-handers.
Kimo Paul is in, but he's not needed at the moment because Tanvir has picked out Cooper. Shadab Khan strikes again. He now goes to the top of the wicket takers in this year's Hero CPL with 8. This young man is absolute dynamite.
Is on a hat trick. 2 from 2 here from the young leggy. And they're loving it, the Red Army. See you later, Sahail. Gone for 11, 1, 31 for 7.
Yeah, wide this time. Had to reach for it. And when you go wide, you don't really have the control and power. Kevin Cooper made it look easy. It's always a very difficult catch to take when it's dipping. But they've done really well. Trimbigo Knight Riders, they're all cricket. Exceptional today.
For 7.
Absolutely loving watching their side. They've taken this lad, Shadab Khan, to their hearts here in Trinidad. A new hero. 8 wickets for 84 in 12 overs in his 4 games so far. Irresistible. Tanvir, I think, would have made it anyway. Shadab goes in front of Kevon Cooper as the highest wicket taker. Another quicker ball, perhaps because he can't grip it. Ball went into orbit. Pierre did the rest. And then Tanvir, who can hit a long, long ball, just wasn't long enough, and Cooper did the rest. And the appeal, well, the appeal was worth a wicket. Clipped away, beaten the man inside the circle. And we'll run away for 4. They need every run they can get here, the Amazon Warriors.
Certainly do, Butch. So still 10 deliveries to go. And we've seen sides already in the Hero CPL 2017 get knocked over. Not use up every delivery at their disposal. 10 to go. Still a lot of deliveries in this fabulous format. And only 3 wickets in the bank for the Warriors. Cooper, such a good exponent of death bowling.
Looking for 2. Ran the first one hard. Throw comes in. Excellent cricket. Alan Bravo out there on the deep mid-wicket boundary.
Well, Dinesh Ramdin was fuming. He expected a more powerful throw from Darren Bravo. Look at it. Bouncing about 5 times before it comes. Come on, Darren. Much more powerful than that. I'm sorry.
Goal.
I know that the Tridents think about Pollard and Puran as the men to finish the innings right now in this current setup.
I think the first angle you saw side on confirmed it that he was all right. Yeah, this one just releases in time, flicks, let go. Yeah, clean for my mind. Saves 2. Come on, Nigel, push the green one.
Settle for 1. They can get themselves anything 150 and above. The Amazon Warriors are in the game. The spin bowlers and seam bowlers are good enough and clever enough. 150 on this surface, not going to be straightforward. McCullum and Munro will come out. Narayan as well, try and blitz it from the start, try and break the back of it early. But then things get interesting as you get past the halfway point on this pitch. Again, they look for 2.12 from the 19th, 143 for 7.
Dozen off that last over. So they've clipped a few here and there. The Warriors, even though they've lost a chunk of wickets, 3, 4, 5, 6 wickets down, now 7.
Now, just confirmation then that Shadab Khan has leapfrogged his partner in crime, Kevon Cooper, to the top of the leading wicket takers in the Hero Caribbean Premier League. No wonder the Knight Riders are at the top of the table, 15 wickets between them, supported by Sunil Narine. Of course, this man, Dwayne Bravo, takes on the responsibility, as always, with the last over. Waked away into the leg side, plenty of cover out there.
Carey Pierre has been on top of his game tonight. On the boundary, 3 catches to the young fella, all off Shadab. He is having a night to remember with this big crowd in. Queen's Park Oval, match 9.
Another hoik into the leg side. That man Pierre again does the cleaning up. Now, it might not have been the most spectacular innings from the Amazon Warriors, but I tell you what's been spectacular, Gary Pierre's catching all from Shadab, and all of them candidates for the Republic Bank Classic catches.
How to put your back out, manual 101. We've seen this so often against Dwayne Bravo, batsman. Get down on one knee and try to slog sweep and heave it into next week. Once again, Bravo, difficult to try and get hold of.
What do you think, Dan? 150, good score for you.
Well, you touched on the butch in terms of breaching that barrier, and it's all about the second 10, isn't it? How many wickets have you got in the bank, and what sort of start do you get off to?
Oh, that's gone long, 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 all the way. Ninth arrow, maximum of the innings.
Well, there's your 150, folks. Munro never had a chance out there. There is that slog sweep down on one knee, and calculating as a batter that he's going to be bowling a lot of these changer, off-cutter, off-spinner type deliveries. Good effort from Colin Munro, but was never in the contest with this one from Kemo Paul. 10 from 5. 2 to go.
I'll look for 2 again. I should get them comfortably. Sometimes the miscue is a good shot at this stage of an innings. Just been informed that this is the highest first inning score in T20 in the last 6 matches here at the Queen's Park Oval. That's including 3 international games, 2 against Pakistan, 1 against West, 1 by the West Indies.
Yeah, challenging as that ball gets old. A very dry surface. So this is very useful total batting first.
Up in the air. I think it looks safe. Freiling turns underneath it. The throw comes in. They'll only pick up 2. Now that constitutes a really good effort. Batting first here at the Queen's Park Oval on a surface that has not been straightforward. Paul and Emrin put on 25 in 13 deliveries in that last partnership.
First one with width on, off and gone! Just like that! That is what can happen in 2020 cricket. Big Gun has gone straight away.
And they know how important that was. They know they've posted a good score. They know they're in with a chance if they pick up early wickets. And if they get rid of Brendan McCullum, then boy, bonanza time. The Rasta Duck in full effect. McCullum gone for North, third ball, not for 1.
Yeah, the angle just had him reaching for it. Had to open the blade. Gajanan Singh looked at that ball all the way into his hands. Didn't want to make any mistake at all because that's a big wicket. Tanvir strikes very early.
One Kiwi replaces another. Here's Colin Munro. Left-hander, so 2 lefties out in the middle now. Yeah, she's a funny old game. These are great numbers from Munro, mind you. And McCullum, just a fraction more bit of bottom hand, just fractionally earlier on the timing, and it would have gone over, cover point easy. That looks out! Oh, is it out? There's a huge shout! Langton! Rousseau, what are you doing?
Oh, I cannot believe the finger has stayed in the pocket here. That just looked absolutely stone dead. It's hit Munro in the shin in front of the lot. It swung late too.
I wish if everyone could have heard the size in the commentary box. Well, it hits him. Middle and leg. Was it going down? The angle. Doubt in the umpire's mind.
Heart in his mouth. You could see he was super nervous when it struck him on the pad. Langton, Rossiya saying going down.
There's a chance for a run out here. Oh, Munro gets out of the way, gets up there at the other end. Best place to bat for him right now is the non-striker's end. I wonder if the position that Munro ended up in was the problem for us up here. There's the end of McCullum.
First ball last year, same opposition, same bowler for Brendan McCullum. Talk about deja vu. One for one here, and it could have been two for one. Should it have been? Oh, a little bit of movement again in, and stand and deliver. Soon on the run, he's underway straight away.
Oh, there's no shortage of excitement here. We're seeing everything in the first over. How's about this for a perfect on-drive from Sunil Narine?
Well, if you think the loss of Brendan McCullum will temper this man, there's no way of stopping his aggression. A little bit of a jig between the two batsmen, but he gets a boundary off his first delivery, Narine.
Wicket, first ball, dot ball, single, and a boundary. That is a key length. Look at the feet, they've gone nowhere, and there is that little bit of pace and extra bounce with a new ball. And McCullum, huge scalp. Golden duck, here is his dismissals so far. Caught by Wright, it was a cracker. But sucked in here from Keswick Williams too, fine piece of bowling. And now this, trying to reach and go early. Very first ball of the innings. Possibly could have been a second wicket with Munro's very first one. On the charge. Ends the first one, 5 for 1 now.
This is what Dan's talking about. Could it have been two? To the naked eye, it looks stone dead. I understand why Langton Pierre said no. The position Munro ends up in afterwards, loses his balance, makes it look worse. And I wonder, could it have missed or clipped leg stump?
Could have been two down. That late swing in. Spin. Useful. Let's see if he can get it to go off the pitch, off the straight, enough to ask questions. Good move. Off spinner going away from the outside edge of the lefties.
Yeah, he's up. Someone that loves the ball round the wicket, angle the ball in. Doesn't really fight the ball. Very flat in the way he bowls. And he'll very rarely turn one. That's all you need as an off spinner. Let the batsman know you can spin it.
Oh, could have been out on another occasion. Gets enough of it, does Munro. Little lucky, little nervy.
I thought he picked him out. I thought he plopped it straight in the hands of mid-on. But I think it's Primus there at mid-on. He'd come in off the edge of the circle. He was about 3 yards in. Just looked over his head.
key to this innings, Munro and Narine, losing McCullum for a golden one. There's more of that bottom hand into it. There's the protection. Done some homework there. That's one of Munro's key areas early on and against spinners in the power play. Here's this LB Butch. It's done a bit, isn't it? It's done. It has hugged in very late.
Munro looked worried. Never took his eyes off the umpire. That's when you know a batsman thinks, oh man, that's close. I think it's a good call. I think it's a good call. You wouldn't have blamed him either way, actually. If he'd given it out, you'd have said fair dues as well.
True. I suppose when you think about you darling batters, this is a batsman's game and we'd like a bit of benefit of the doubt. This should be a wide. Yeah, there's an extra. Mr. Brathwaite, a little bit of exercise. Bales came off. Walton with the gloves on. He's asking and just hustling the very young Langton Rasir from Zimbabwe. They're on his case. Zimbabwe out here for the Hero CPL, fifth edition. Well, that's turned. There you go, Darren Ganga.
I told you so. And it will just like awaken the demons in Sunil's mind. A little bit of spin, the dry surface. It's probably a little bit of rough from the foot marks as well.
And that tells you all you need to know about this pitch. A man who never turns one off the straight, turns one square. Yeah, now Narine doesn't know whether to stick or twist. Keep you in your crease for sure when one rags past you like that.
There's a beauty. Oh, here he goes, open that front leg, and oh, it's through! Has it got enough? No, this is a very good effort. Alarazan, wonderful stuff to finish out the over. Save two runs, 13 for one.
Quick there, Alarazan. Running all the way around from long off. Brilliant athletic stuff.
Gorgeous evening here in the capital. Jewel. Oh, sounded good, but has he got enough of it? Oh, you better believe it. That is up there in the second tier from Colin Munro. Wonderful piece of striking early in over number three.
Oh, the agony and the ecstasy. Tanvir had everyone tied up in knots in the first over. No swing this time. Munro gets himself out of his crease and pop this one over mid-on. It's a biggie.
That's why he's third on the list of the most runs this year's competition. Very prolific, powerful strike off the ball.
A little punch, double the running. Classic stuff from Munro.
Yeah, you poor bowlers. I'm going to feign a bit of sympathy for you. Tanvir had one over where the ball swung. Well, two balls in his second over, gun barrel straight. And Munro has just pinged it through extra cover.
He just checked his shot. That's when you know batsman has perfect timing. He's in really good nick, Colin Munro. He's grown accustomed to the conditions here at the Queen's Park Oval. Home venue for the Trinbago Knight Riders.
Oh yeah, it's on. You can sense it. There's no swing there.
batters are going to have a free license just to thrash it to all parts. Live from the QPO. Sold out crowd, yeah, you know it. Loving the Hawaiian blue. Yeah, Darren Ganga with the matching pants. He's all over it as the fashion guru from the Port of Spain. Yeah, checked out the trowel.
We keep getting sledged walking outside of the ground here. People are saying they haven't worn shirts like this in the Caribbean since the 60s.
Just need to know how to style it, guys.
Well, they certainly won't miss us. We're outside the ground trying to get back to the hotel.